Okay. All right, so I got the E1 connected to LAN port 1, connected to my computer. Open up eBuddy, and you can see I did a refresh, and we have the E1 here. Before I did that, I opened up eCatcher. I hit add, and I added AirClear maintenance. Go to properties. Here's the key for it. So my next step is I'm going to set the IP address, serial number. I'll come back to this so you can see I'll set the serial number and the password. Well, let me go ahead and do that. Serial number 2149-0258-22. Username. Okay, I use username and left username and password blank because I hadn't set one. So then I'm going to set the IP address 192.168.0.53, the one we've been using. Hit next, and it'll go ahead and reboot it and set the IP address. And I'll come back. All right, now you can see that the IP address is set. Also, I think I said in the email I only use eCatcher. I was wrong. You have to use eBuddy also. Apologize. All right, I'll get back to the next step in a second. All right, so I changed my IP address to be on the same network. And in my browser, I put that address for the E1. And you see it comes up with username and password. Both of them are ADM, ADM lowercase. And I log in. English. Okay. Now you see there's a wizard here. Here's the wizard. Launch the wizard. Where I left off, but you copy the activation to the clipboard and you go back here after you've established your internet, put in your password. Excuse me, your key. You see the AirClear maintenance is online. You can connect. I'm not sure what this overlap is. I think it's when I was having problems setting everything up. I think maybe I addressed the Quran and the land to the same address. But I think you kind of get the idea. To back here on the on this wizard here, let's go through this again. Want to make sure it's DHCP. You know, we shouldn't have to go to the next one. I just wanted to go through and show you. Probably have to clear this error up sometime, but that's the gist of it. I went back through the configuration setup and got rid of the error, and you can see that the IP addresses that are accessible are the PLC and the HMI. There you go.